As we age, the loss of cognitive brain function in the form of Alzheimer's, dementia will unfortunately be an issue for many people. So the question is, can we do something beginning now to slow or maybe even stop the onset of this vicious disease? Well, most of us know that the benefits of aerobic exercise are great for our heart, but there's a growing mountain of evidence that suggests that consistent aerobic exercise can actually grow our brains as well and dramatically reduce the odds of cognitive decline as we age. In this video, we'll discuss the powerful effects of exercise on the brain, the areas of the brain that are impacted the most, how exercise actually grows the brain, what type of exercise do we need to do, and how long do we need to exercise to get the maximum brain-boosting benefits. Ready to learn about the aerobic exercise and brain health connection? Let's talk about it. Hello everybody, it's Mark, and we are back with a video all about the brain health-boosting benefits of aerobic exercise. Let's jump in. Sorry to say it, but none of us is getting any younger. We can't stop the aging process, so the question is, what can we do now to slow or reduce the typical consequences of aging, specifically the effect that getting older has on our brain's cognitive function abilities? Now, I'm sure many of us have seen or been directly impacted by the devastating effects that Alzheimer's or dementia has had on someone we know or someone we love. It is a vicious, vicious disease that slowly robs people of their memories and ultimately, in many cases, their identity itself. Now, my mother is currently suffering from dementia, so I've become acutely aware of its effects on her over these last few years. She's experienced a steady decline in her cognitive function, and there is virtually nothing that can be done about it at this point. And that's incredibly frustrating. Now, my mother was always healthy. She never had any chronic diseases or anything like that over her 85 plus years. And yet she's being subjected to this cruel disease at the end of her life. Now, this has me asking, is there something that I or anybody else can do to reduce the odds of getting dementia or Alzheimer's? There is some good news in this regard. And the good news is that, yes, there does seem to be a way to dramatically reduce the impact of age-related mental decline. And that is by doing aerobic exercise. Now, before we talk about how aerobic exercise helps the brain, let's spend a minute or so learning about the brain and what parts of the brain seem to benefit the most from aerobic exercise. Now, there are two primary areas of the brain that Alzheimer's and dementia seems to affect. The first area is called the hippocampus, which is Greek for seahorse. Now, the hippocampus is located deep in the brain behind the ears, and we actually have two of them, one on each side of our brain. Now, the hippocampi is the organ that kind of deals, or the part of the brain that deals with the consolidation and management of memories. Now, the types of memories that the hippocampus processes include two basic types. The first one is what are called spatial memories. So basically, navigations and pathways, how we get around in the world. The other memory type is declarative memories. So think of things like facts and events. Now, the hippocampus does a lot. It also works to consolidate memories while we sleep. It manages short-term memories and turns them into long-term memories. And it also works in the connecting of memories to emotions and sensations. So it does a lot. Now, the other part of the brain that Alzheimer's dementia seems to affect is what's called the prefrontal cortex. And this is located in the front of your brain, kind of right behind the eyes. The prefrontal cortex is responsible for what's called executive function. So things like planning, decision-making, working memory, those types of things, as well as personality and social expression. So in patients with Alzheimer's or dementia, the hippocampus and prefrontal cortex are two primary areas of the brain to show damage, actually reducing in size, which indicates a loss of brain cells. So basically, the hippocampus and prefrontal cortex are the parts of the brain that really help us associate and link things together that we've experienced in the past, present, or may in the future. They help us make decisions and allow us to express ourselves. They essentially help make us who we are, and any damage to them kind of takes away part of us by literally denying us of our memories. Now, how does exercise, specifically aerobic exercise, help our hippocampus and prefrontal cortex remain strong and vital late into life? Well, a lot of research has been done on this over the years, but one of the more recent neuroscientists to really focus on exercise and brain health is Dr. Wendy Suzuki. She's with New York University. Now, she works to understand memory, attention, and simple daily habits that can be used to improve learning, focus, and cognitive ability. Now, she did a TED Talk in 2018 titled "The Brain-Changing Effects of Exercise." And this talk promoted the many positive benefits of exercise on brain health that she had found in her research. So I'll post a link to the talk in the description below. Now, I watched this TED Talk a year or so ago, and it really connected with me because of my mother and her battle against dementia. Now, unfortunately for my mother, it's probably too late to significantly change anything. But for me and everyone else who is not currently suffering from the effects of Alzheimer's or dementia, Dr. Suzuki talks about the powerful impact that exercise, especially aerobic exercise, can have on brain health. Here's how exercise changes the brain. First, when you exercise, especially doing aerobic or cardio exercise, your body releases chemicals that go into the brain and signal the release of what's called BDNF, or brain-derived neurotrophic factor. Now, the word neurotrophic means growth, so BDNF actually promotes the growth of new brain cells, strengthening the brain, particularly in the hippocampus and prefrontal cortex areas. Now, this helps the brain resist the decline in functioning due to Alzheimer's and dementia. Now, the chemicals come from two sources while exercising, the muscles and the liver. Now, muscles release a protein that's called myokine, and the liver releases a ketone called beta-hydroxybutyrate. Both of these chemicals are unique in that they are able to pass through that blood-brain barrier and actually go into the brain itself, where they stimulate the release of the BDNF. And as Dr. Suzuki describes it, the BDNF almost acts like a bubble bath for your brain, bathing your brain in BDNF and all these other helpful chemicals, and helps to build what she calls a big, fat, fluffy hippocampus. Now, this big, fat, fluffy hippocampus is what helps us fight off the effects of reduced brain function as we age. So the effects of exercise on the brain are immediate as well as long-lasting. Almost any type of moderate exercise that you do, going for a brisk walk, for example, if you do that for at least 10 minutes, you're going to notice a few immediate benefits. One, you're going to get an improvement in your mood and energy level. You'll get greater focus and attention. You will decrease your reaction time, in other words, be able to react faster to things going on around you. You'll also decrease anxiety, depression, and feelings of hostility. Now, these effects seem to last a minimum of 2 hours after exercise, but many people, myself included, notice these benefits pretty much for the rest of the day. So obviously, these are some very positive immediate benefits of exercise. And when you add that to the long-term brain-building benefits, an aerobic exercise all of a sudden seems to be kind of a wonder drug when it comes to brain health. Now, to really get that brain bubble bath of BDNF and all the brain cell generating benefits, research has shown that the exercise needs to be cardio or aerobic focused and last for at least 20 to 30 minutes. Now, you don't have to blow yourself up doing high intensity intervals, sprints, or maximum efforts. Just go out and get a consistent elevated heart rate That's pretty much all it takes. So something that gets you a little out of breath, but leaves you still able to carry on a conversation with occasional breaks. Something like that, that's what it takes, and that's gonna be what does the trick. Does that sound like something else I've talked about in previous videos? Yep, if you watch some of my earlier videos, you've seen a number of them talking about what's called zone 2 training. And that's essentially what moderate exercise is, zone 2. So think of going out and doing a nice zone 2 workout, and you're going to be right in that sweet spot of your BDNF bubble bath zone. Now try to do a minimum of 3 to 4 of these sessions each week. If you can do something aerobic every day, hey, the benefits are even greater. So really the bottom line is that moderate aerobic exercise done on a regular, consistent basis can greatly improve the odds that you'll go later and later into life without having to deal with the impact of reduced brain function. Now, is exercise a cure for Alzheimer's or dementia? No, nothing indicates that it is, but it does seem to significantly increase your brain's ability to resist the effects of these diseases for a longer and longer period. And for me, that's more than enough evidence that means that I'm going to focus on getting consistent aerobic exercise every day for the rest of my life. Hope you found this video useful. If you did, help YouTube share it with others by smashing that thumbs up button. Give us a big thumbs up. That really helps. And if you want to be part of the community that we're building here, go ahead and subscribe. Click that subscribe button. We'd love to have you as part of the family. Now, to see more videos on the benefits of aerobic exercise and zone 2 training, check out this playlist up here. That's it for now. Remember, the goal isn't just to live life, but to live life better. Until the next one, be well.